Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. The Bank of England today raised interest rates to 0.75%, the highest level in almost 10 years. The hike is only the second since the financial crisis and means interest rates are higher than at any time since March 2009. The pound briefly rose against both the euro and the dollar when the rate was confirmed but quickly fell back into the red against both currencies. It will mean higher mortgage bills for the 3.7 million people on variable and tracker mortgages, but could also help savers who have suffered a decade of miserable rates. Experts said borrowers can expect to pay about an extra £6 a month for every £50,000 on a 20-year mortgage. At the end of 2017, 1.3 million mortgages were trackers and 1.8 million were standard variable rate SVRs. Calculations by UK Finance suggest a 0.25 percentage point base rate rise passed on in full to borrowers could add around £16 to monthly repayments for those on tracker rates and around £12 on an SVR, based on typical amounts outstanding. The Bank of England today raised interest rates to 0.75%, the highest level in almost 10 years. Rates are still far lower than average over the past 30 years. What are banks and building societies doing to implement the rate rise? Here is what providers have said so far. RBS, the Royal Bank of Scotland, NatWest and Ulster Bank. North base rate has also increased from 0.5% to 0.75%. For those customers on base rate linked products, it will increase their rate to 0.75%. Variable rate products will be reviewed. Lloyds Banking Group, Halifax. All products that track the Bank of England base rate will be increased by 0.25% from September. Santander, it is reviewing the pricing of all of its variable rates that are not linked to the base rate. All tracker mortgage products linked to the base rate, including Santander's follow-on rate, will move in line with the change. All loans to UK businesses linked to the base rate will move in line with the change and in accordance with the terms of the deal. All savings products linked to the base rate will move in line with the increase from the end of August. HSBC tracker mortgages will go up on Friday in line with the base rate. Other mortgage rates and savings will be reviewed. Nationwide changes to all products are under review. Today's decision was announced at noon following the regular meeting of the bank's Monetary Policy Committee, which is chaired by Governor Mark Carney, pictured today at the Bank of England. Today's decision was announced at noon following a unanimous 9-0 vote of the bank's Monetary Policy Committee, which is chaired by Governor Mark Carney. The bank kept its forecast for UK growth unchanged at 1.4% in 2018, but upped its prediction for next year to 1.8%. Mr. Carney said the modest rise in interest rates was an appropriate response to inflation, which is still rising faster than its 2% target and putting pressure on wages. Speaking at a press conference after the rates announcement, he said, UK growth in the second quarter is estimated to have rebounded as expected. He confirmed the prospect for further rises as he said if rates stayed at 0.75%, inflation would remain above 2% throughout the forecast horizon. But he said, rate rises are expected to be limited and gradual. Rates can be expected to rise gradually. Policy needs to walk, not run, to stand still, he added. During the financial crisis, rates were slashed to the emergency low of 0.5% in an effort to contain the fallout from the financial crisis. The pound briefly rose against both the euro, left, and the dollar, right, when the rate was confirmed but quickly fell back into the red against both currencies. Slowing economic growth has been cited by many analysts for delays in the interest rate hike that was finally announced today. Brian Murphy, head of lending at Mortgage Advice Bureau, said those on tracker variable mortgages would see higher bills. Will any raise in rates be passed on to savers? Savers should not simply hold out for a base rate increase before moving their money, with rates on easy access accounts having crept up by only around 0.07 percentage points since the last rise, according to experts. The average live easy access account pays 0.42%, an increase of only 0.07 percentage points compared with September 2017 when it was 0.35%, figures from website Savings Champion show. This is despite the Bank of England base rate increasing by 0.25 points in early November 2017. Many high street banks have chopped their rates to the bone, it said. Savings champion said providers track rate movements so loosely that some accounts have remained unchanged following November's base rate increase from 0.25% to 0.5%. He said, for those with a tracker mortgage linked directly to the BoE base rate, for every £50,000 of borrowing on a 20-year term mortgage, the interest rate change today would increase their payments by £6 per month. Craig McKinley, sales and marketing director at Kensington Mortgages, said, if November's rate rise was important for its symbolism, today's rate rise is equally important for its message to the market. The record low interest rate era is over, and interest rates are now headed in one direction. For recent homeowners, a rate rise will still be a new and uncertain experience, but it's important to remember that this is still only a slight increase from previous levels. We're still a long way off from the 5-6% mark 10 years ago. This rise should be a call to action for those borrowers who haven't yet remortgaged to get in touch with a mortgage broker and seek a new competitive deal. After unexpectedly holding rates in May, the bank edged a step closer to pressing the button in June when its chief economist Andy Haldane joined two fellow policymakers in calling for a rise. A rate hike changes the calculations for Chancellor Philip Hammond's next budget in November. He is pictured on budget day last year. Raising interest rates should cool inflation, blue line, which is still above its 2% target and close to wages, pressuring workers. Minutes from the Bank of England's MPC meeting showed the committee viewed the recent downturn in UK economic growth as a temporary blip. The minutes said, although the global outlook was a little softer, recent data appeared to confirm that the dip in UK output in the first quarter had been temporary, with momentum recovering in the second quarter. The labour market had continued to tighten and unit labour cost growth had firmed. Given these developments, a 0.25 percentage point increase in bank rate was warranted at this meeting to return inflation sustainably to the target. The minutes explained that Brexit is still one of the most important considerations for the bank's rate-setting committee. Shadow Chancellor John McDonnell said, with wages still below 2010 levels and the gap between people's income and outgoings at record levels, the concern must be that a pattern of interest rate rises will push more families into higher levels of debt. The government needs to end its counterproductive austerity program and raise people's incomes. The bank's last move to raise rates in November from 0.25% to 0.5% was the first such move for more than 10 years, but merely reversed the cut made in the aftermath of the Brexit vote. Shadow Chancellor John McDonnell, file image, warned higher rates risked pushing the poor deeper into debt.